started out getting into music, I guess, first. You know, singing was my way of performing, singing at talent shows and singing at church and listening to records and stuff like that. But I quickly fell in love with acting as well. I remember watching, you know, Kids Incorporated or like Growing Pains and this movie, My Girl. You know, I quickly got into the mindset that I loved stories and I loved acting as well as singing. And so it became more important to me to just, you know, how could I perform? How could I write my own stories, be a part of making things? My parents ended up inspiring me because what they would listen to is what I would listen to. And I remember one of my first favorite songs being Imagine by John Lennon. I loved Carole King, Tapestry. My mom listened to that album all the time, and The Carpenters. I used to learn like all their words. You'd just sit in front of the record player with all the lyric sheets. But then as I got older, I definitely was into MTV Beach House in the summer. I would watch, you know, Sisters with Voices. I don't even remember that group. I loved them, and I was obsessed with Mariah Carey as well. One thing that's really great about The Walking Dead fans is they are so supportive and open, and they'll come to my shows, even if they're not sure it's going to be their thing or not. They come, and then I think a lot of people do end up listening to the stories and the words and sort of end up deciding they like the music as well. But I do find that it's a surprise. I don't know what people expect when they see someone who's an actor, and then it's like, oh, you know, now they're doing music. But really, I've done music all along, you know. It's been like a part of my life, and I hope will always be a part of my life. So I find that people are really surprised by what they hear. I don't know what kinds of stories they expect me to tell, but, you know, I tell stories about living in New York and boyfriends and identity and, you know, trying to figure life out. When I first got cast on the show, that's right when I was finishing up Blue Toothbrush. So I had given people my EP because I like, oh my God, I finally came out, you know, and I just did it through like CD Baby and me and my friends. But between seasons two and seasons three, it was actually Glenn Mazzara's idea. I don't know if he saw a show or one of the writers had seen me do a show at Rockwood. So they knew that if they wanted that to be part of the character that they could do that. And I think that he had told me he was looking for moments where we could have like moments of calm and ways, you know, to let people into Beth's sort of life. And it's funny how, you know, when you see someone sing, you feel like you know them in a certain way. So even though she wasn't doing, you know, it was a way for the audience to sort of connect who she was. That song at the piano at the funeral home was one of the ones where we were really searching for the right song. Because Scott said he knew that he wanted there to be that moment of like, you know, singing and finding the piano and stuff. Because Daryl makes fun of her in one of the earlier episodes for singing, you know. So they needed that moment, and it was just like finding the right song. And, you know, I think what's cool about the show is they do try to find music that maybe not everyone has heard a lot of. So something different but has the right message. We went through a lot of songs, and, you know, I would even like learn them on the piano, send him a like little iPhone voice memo, and he'd be like, ooh, that's cool, that one's cool, that one maybe wouldn't work, that one, you know. So we like went through a few songs, and I was really happy when we decided to do that one, because I really like Waxahachie.